Hello friends, my name is Fanindra and in this video let us discuss about rolling circular replication, which is shortly abbreviated as RCR. And this rolling circular replication was mainly discovered by Waxman and Crick in 1990s, and it is a unidirectional. Why they mentioned that unidirectional? Because the direction of this replication is only at the one side. So in the name it indicates only uni means single side, single direction means side, only one side of replication takes place. Hence it is named as unidirectional. Coming to the third point, synthesis of many copies of DNA and RNA. Due to this rolling circular replication, the one of the DNA particle will be the formation of two daughter individuals of two DNAs, and 2 to 4, 4 to 8. In this way, synthesization of many copies of DNA and RNA takes place due to the rolling circular replication process. So what are the best example of this rolling circular replication? Plasmids, bacteriophages, virots, and prokaryotes. So plasmid mainly consists of DNA, and the DNA will undergo this rolling circular replication, and the bacteriophages also consists of such type of genome, whether it consists of DNA or else RNA, and that will undergo rolling circular replication. And the virots mainly consists of RNA, but it doesn't consist of DNA, it consists of only RNA, and that RNA is also in the genetic material which is present in these virots is RNA, and that RNA is in the circular shape. So that genome will undergo rolling circular replication. This rolling circular replication is only noticed for the genetic material which is in the circular form only. If it is not in circular form, then it doesn't undergo rolling circular replication. So there are four examples given for you, and that four examples, the genetic material which is present in that four examples is in the circular form. Due to the presence of that circular form, it undergoes rolling circular replication. So in virots, there consists of RNA which is in the circular form, so it exhibits rolling circular replication. And in eukaryotes, some of the eukaryotes consists of DNA and some eukaryotes consists of RNA. Both the DNA and RNA undergoes rolling circular replication. So one of the important point which you have to remember is the rolling circular replication can be only useful for the genetic material of the organisms which is in the circular form. Okay. So coming to the process of this rolling circular replication, so how the process takes place, how the DNA is mainly undergoes replication. So this is a double stranded DNA, and the red color strand which is known as first strand, and the blue color one is known as second strand. So when this first strand and second strand, this is known as double stranded DNA. DSDNA is nothing but double stranded DNA, and here there is a black color two dots I have drawn there, right, which is known as REP protein. That is nothing but it is an initiator replication protein. What is the main function of that initiator replication protein? And that initiator replication protein will be attached to the second strand. That is nothing but blue color I have said you, blue color means second strand, right? And that replication initiator protein will be attached to that blue color strand. That is nothing but second strand. So what happens? Due to the replication, the strand will be broken. Which strand? Second strand. The blue color strand will be broken. That is the main function of this replication initiator protein. And here I have mentioned you oricite. O-R-I. Oricite. Oricite means origin site. Origin site of replication. What is this origin site of replication? It is nothing but the site where the initiation of replication takes place is known as origin site. Exactly. If you see here, there is a protein attached here. Due to that protein, what happens? There is a breaking of strand takes place. That is nothing but replication. Initiation of replication takes place. Where it takes place? It is oricite, and that position is known as oricite, which is nothing but origin site. And poly3 enzyme, what happens? There is a formation of 5' and 3' ends. As if you see here, replication initiator protein will be attached to the second strand. So due to the strand, what happens? The strand will get divided. If you see here, there is a broken of the strand. Due to that broken, what happens? There is a formation of 5' and 3'. As you know that 5' consists of phosphate group and 3' consists of hydroxyl group. Okay, fifth strand consists of, that is nothing but 5' end consists of phosphate group, whereas 3' end consists of hydroxyl group. So here I have mentioned the formation of 5' and 3' ends. So after this process, what happens? If you see here, there is a division takes place in the second strand due to the enzyme, due to the protein initiation, REP protein, replication protein. What happens? There is a formation of 5' and 3'. After that, what happens? The whole strand of the, that is nothing but the whole second strand will be replicated. That is nothing but it starts nicking. What is mean by nicking? Nicking means separating. Which separation takes place? The first strand and second strand separation takes place. So if you see here, the second strand is gets escaping from the first strand due to the process called nicking. Okay, nicking is nothing but separating. So what happens again? Second strand which has been escaped from that first strand will again rejoin. That is nothing but it attains its original shape. Okay. It again rejoin and becomes again circular in shape, as the red color one, that is nothing but first strand will be remain as it is, but the second strand will get rejoined. Okay, and that after this process, what happens with both of the strands will get separated, which first strand and second strand, that is nothing but first strand is nothing but red color one and second strand is nothing but blue color one. Both of them will get separated from this division. Okay, and with the help of DNA ligase enzyme, not only the DNA ligase but also with the help of poly-3 enzyme, what happens? The both will attain the same as usual up to here. If you see here, there is a double stranded DNA. With the help of DNA ligase and poly-3 enzyme, what happens? The next strand will also get here. If you see here, there is a blue color one means which one? Second strand. So if you see in this this diagram, what happens here? There is a red color strand which has been appeared. How this appeared? Because of the enzyme known as DNA ligase or as poly-3 enzyme. Due to this enzyme, there is a second strand appearing. Okay, there is nothing but a red color strand which is appearing. So if you see here, there is a first strand, but there is absence of second strand. So in this diagram, if you see, there is a presence of the second strand also. With the help of how the process takes place? With the help of an enzyme known as DNA ligase or poly-3 enzyme. Okay, so what is the main function of this DNA ligase or poly-3 enzyme? It is mainly used for the process of DNA recombination. DNA recombination is nothing but attaining of another strand is known as DNA recombination. In simple words, we can say that attaining of second strand, another strand, or else another strand is known as DNA recombination. Okay, so this is the process of the rolling circular replication. So hope you understand this video, guys. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment in the comment box. Thank you.